Warren Buffett is putting his money where his company is after months of sitting on a stockpile of cash on hand, which, by the way, grew to more than $146 billion by the end of June. Berkshire Hathaway spent a record $5.1 billion buying back its own stock in the second quarter and may very well have kept up the buying spree in July, indicating that Buffett thinks Berkshire is undervalued. Right now, A shares up 1.5%, same with the B shares. Now, while quarterly profits did rebound, more on that in a sec, the company saw a 10% slump in operating income last quarter. Couple of issues, because the pandemic wreaked havoc on many of its 70-plus businesses. Burlington Northern Railroad taking a hit with the rest of the travel and shipping industry, and Berkshire was forced to take a $9.8 billion impairment charge on Precision Cast Parts. This is the airplane parts manufacturer. It scooped up in 2016 for about $32 billion. I mean, that was a big, big acquisition. It hasn't quite played out the way Buffett probably hoped at the moment. GEICO, its auto insurance behemoth, did see a temporary bump due to fewer auto traffic problems and fewer accidents, but now warning its 15% discount that it gave, equaling close to $3 billion to drivers who renew their policies, that could actually trigger underwriting losses for the rest of the year. But in the end, Buffett's waking up and saying, thank you, Apple. Its net income jumped 86% last quarter to more than $26 billion because of its massive investment in Apple shares. Here's a look at how Apple is doing right now. It's up 1.5% to $450.91 a share. The tech giant is Berkshire's largest holding. So you know Buffett's always keeping an eye on it. But what else is the Oracle, or at least during the quarter, was he interested in? To Ashley Webster, Ashley, he was buying stock, was he not?
He was indeed. It's interesting as you went over some of those highlights there. The stock buyback, the biggest one, no doubt. $4.6 billion worth of that was in the Class B shares. So yes, you're right, Liz. Maybe he does think that side is undervalued. But what's interesting is he picked up another huge lot of Bank of America shares, $2 billion worth to be clear, and that, by the way, puts him as the largest position he has. Now, wait a minute, you'll say, no, Apple is his biggest holding. Well, yes, by value, but by number of shares, Mr. Buffett has his biggest bet, if you like, on Bank of America, which is interesting because Wells Fargo and maybe JP Morgan Chase have been a bit of a laggard when you compare it to some of these other stocks. Especially Apple and Amazon. So it's very interesting that he doubled down, if you like, on B of A. He also cashed out on the airlines. I think he threw in the towel there in May, cashed them all out. It's going to take a long time for the airlines to recover from the COVID-19, of course, the pandemic, and when people will get back to normal, if ever, at this stage. You mentioned the big acquisition in 2016. That was really the last big mega deal that Berkshire Hathaway has done. Yes, they bought Dominion Energy for 10 billion back in early July, but not on a mega scale. And they have all of this cash. Okay, they're buying stock back, but where will he go with that cash in the future? We'll have to wait and see. That cash pile grew by $9 billion from the last quarter, which was a tough quarter. As we know, the stock dropped 19% because of what the pandemic had done to many, many industries. But as you say, Liz, interesting way to see where he goes. But that big acquisition of Bank of America shares raised a few eyebrows.
Yeah, and you know what? You're looking at Precision Cast Parts years later, since 2016, yeah. 10,000 job losses. So we'll be keeping an eye on that, as we know. Listen, airplane parts, Boeing, travel's not happening. We'll be watching it. Ashley, thank you very much. Right. But that Apple investment, boy, that's been a winner for Warren Buffett. Closing bell ringing in 6 minutes, Dow at 353. The small...